Hello, in this video we are going to speak about such a common regex construct as a word boundary. A word boundary is a position at the beginning of the string if the first character is a word character. Word boundary also occurs after the last character in the string if the last character is a word character. Also, the word boundary occurs between two characters in the string where one of the characters is a word character and the other is not a word character. A word character is roughly a letter, digit, or underscore. A non-word character is roughly a character other than a digit, letter, or underscore. Now let's try and match a whole word is. So if we just type is, we'll match any is substring in any string. In order to make it a whole word match, we add word boundaries. Backslash b on each side. You can see that we matched all is substrings on the first, second, and third lines below the match section title. If we take under consideration this first is, we can see that it is located at the beginning of a line. It is preceded with a new line character, and a new line character is a non-word character. And this word is followed by comma, and a comma is also a non-word character. Same happens with the second occurrence. A comma and hyphen are non-word characters. The exclamation mark is also a non-word character. A new line is a non-word character. And space is also a non-word character. Now, you can see that we didn't match is on the line with underscores and on the line where digits are glued to the letters. Now you remember that word boundaries are based on the distinction between word and non-word characters. Since word characters are not just letters, they also include digits and underscores. We need to be able to exclude either digits or underscores or both from the word boundaries. In order to do that, we need to use lookarounds. That is, we can use a look behind that matches a position that is immediately preceded with an underscore or a word boundary. And we need to use a positive look ahead that matches a location that is immediately followed by an underscore or a word boundary. This is not the only solution. We can also use these two negative lookarounds that are basically the same, but you avoid using alternation inside them, thus making them a bit more efficient, but a bit more cryptic. Okay, there is another test case left. Here, we've got the word is that is surrounded with both underscores and digits. So, in order to exclude digits, we can just add backslash d in these negative lookarounds. And we've got our two remaining matches. In order to match is substring not inside letters, you can also use a much simpler pattern like this. You just use the letter pattern in the lookarounds. You can also use a Unicode character class here. Like this. Now there are a lot of other types of boundaries, for example numeric boundaries. For example, if you want to match 4 but not the 4 in 143. So you can see an example here. There are white space boundaries. Now when you use word boundaries inside your code, make sure you escape the backslashes properly. In regular string literals, in order to define a single literal backslash, you need to use two backslashes. In most programming languages, you can use verbatim or raw string literals, where backslashes are treated as normal characters. Please use those verbatim or raw string literals to define your regular expression patterns. That will help you avoid many other issues related to regular expressions. Remember that if you need help with code, you can always check the code generator page here at regex101.com. Now you can see the explanation of the pattern on the right. You can read more about word boundaries by following the links in the further links section, and if you liked my video, please click like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet. Thank you for watching, and happy regexing!